الكيسة حي الكيسة انت عطيني
حكمية عدو وحضا لبته عينك هذا حي عدالة النخصين عينك هذا حي عدالة
وفتيغن بلاران اي كسودة شركة دي بي ويل اي دل كيسو تاق امارات كعربتا او هو قامين ايو اغا اسمها قود اي شركة دا دبي بول وود اي امركا يسو قارين مدارك بربرا واحد دل كسو دوغيي حبنا كمي دا قولها وسيرة دا انتا كدب وفود دا واحد لوسو قلبيي قودها مقال حيبات دا بربرا اذا
العديه فينو خبر لغا دورا ايو
ما ندى هاي ليدي إذا نهجر دمي أنت غوك يسروح الكيسة 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 أنت تي الكيسة 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 أنت تي
حكمية عدو وحضا لبته عينك هذا حي عدالة النخصين عينك هذا حي عدالة النخصين حكمية عدو وحضا لبته عينك هذا حي عدالة النخصين عينك هذا حي
وحضا لبته
عدالتا نخرسي عينك هذا حي عدالتا نخرسي حقامية عدو وحضالة بده عينك هذا حي عدالتا نخرسي عينك هذا حي عدالتا نخرسي عينك هذا حي عدالة النهرسي عينك هذا حي عدالة النهرسي عينك هذا حي عدالة النهرسي
حرونت مدحتوية دا قبل كالساحل مركي اي سوق قد قلين وفتقو وحاسب اللارون وقابلي مسؤولين كترسن حكومة دا سومالي لان قدر نسشاء اي كو قاتين حرونتا ايقو وفتقو الله كلمي مدحوينها كمورية دا سومالي لان ايقو قدوميا حسبقا كلمي اهنا مرشحا مدحوينة اي حسبقا او اي وهليان حمنا كترسن قولها وسيره دا
وشير حمانك من كنت نور
banku ila wikida kashi
Dadkan degay ba dadkan degay ba shaxdi kalbiye
Dadkan degay ba dadkan degay ba shaxdi kalbiye Gudiya uma haystaru godabo godabo Qashayra quman kuman gutano Banku ila wikida kashi وكان
كان جرسيل بيا قبني مدار كان جرسيل بيا قبني مو
وشاد الطبي وطايق وبشو وانا قد كارقي وقام بينا يو إني قم بيها نسو كنت
madaxda sare ee Somaliland oo hoggaaminaya madaxweynaha jamhuuriyadda Somaliland iyo mas'uuliyiinta shirkadda DP World ayaa ka qayb galay munaasabad si wanaagsan loo soo agaasimay oo lagu kala wareegay maamulka dekedda Berbera madaxa waxaa ku sugnaa gudoomiyaha xisbiyada kulmiye iyo uciid wasiirro marwada madaxweynaha Somaliland iyo mas'uuliyiin ka socotay dalalka Ruushka iyo Ethiopia iyo marti sharaf kale khudbada kala duwan ay munaasabada ka jeediyeen madaxda Somaliland iyo kuwa shirkadda DP World
We have been operating this port since March, and we have found the people of Berbera and Somaliland very welcoming and very excited. I would like to thank the staff in the port the society and everybody for the warm welcome to stage to say a few words.
Excellency President Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanio, dignitaries, Excellencies ministers, ladies and gentlemen, a greeting from His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, President UAE, to the people of Somaliland, greeting of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, a greeting of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Prime Minister and ruler of Dubai, and a greeting from the people of Dubai to the people of Somaliland. I am delighted and proud to be with you here today. We have been in discussion with the officials here in Somaliland under the guidance of His Excellency the President to eventually come to an agreement to manage this important port. Berbera was a very important trade port for the region. Inshallah, with your help, we need to bring that legacy back to this region. Whatever we do in Berbera here complements whatever we're doing in Africa. We are in 6 locations in Africa. Africa is the fastest growing economy in the world. Both you see in Africa, you don't see anywhere. There are over 200 million people in landlocked countries in Africa where there is no port, including Ethiopia and many, many others. The number is even more than 200 million people. The expectation is that also the growth in population, they expect in the next 5 years 450 million people to join the workforce. In Dubai, we developed our country by enabling trade. In Dubai, we do not have oil. We don't have gas, we don't have water. But we had vision and belief in our economy, belief in our ability. A country, when they are facing challenges of the scarcity of resources, they have two choices. One choice is they pull their hand and they ask for handout from IMF, from World Bank, from many countries that help. That is the easy way. And the hard way is to generate revenue from your own country. In Dubai, we decided to generate revenue and create jobs for our people from our resources, our knowledge, our vision. We recommend, and we are happy, we recommended and we are happy that with the guidance of the President and the ministers, Somaliland decided to rely on their own self and not to wait for handouts. Somaliland is 4 million people, a wealth of a human resource. The human resource wealth is more important than revenue, more important than resources, though more important than oil, more important than mines, because the brain creates more revenue that is not ending, infinite. Oil will finish, mine will finish, but ideas of the people will not finish. Mr. President, you created a peaceful, tranquil country in the middle of very volatile environment and dangerous environment. This is a testament that the people of Somaliland support you, People of Somaliland believe in their ability, believe in their future. In Dubai, we believe in our future. We did not listen to people deciding our fate. We decided our fate. And our fate is, what can we do when we have no resources? Only go to what we used to do better before. What did we do before? We trade. Berbera was an important trade route in the past. Berbera will be a very important trade route in the future. The future of Somaliland depends on the port of Berbera and the development of Berbera. The people of Dubai are so excited. They want to participate in investing here. Today, for example, some people in Dubai, they heard we are coming and they rushed to come with us. So there are four businessmen with us. Of course, I must also thank His Excellency Mr. Mohammed Saif Al-Suwaidi, the Director General of Abu Dhabi Development Fund. The Abu Dhabi Development Fund is an entity that the government of Abu Dhabi has established, which has one goal, how to help develop resources for other countries. Many multi-billion dollars have been donated in soft loans by the Abu Dhabi Monetary Development Fund in helping countries. We believe in Abu Dhabi and UAE that you don't give people money because money will go, but you participate in developing project that will generate revenue for the people. The Development Fund of Abu Dhabi has the expertise and the knowledge to guide and invest in something that will be positive for you. We are proud that Mr. Suwaidi joined us today. Also, there are four big businessmen with us today from big prominent families. One of them is Mr. Isa Al-Gurair, where they are involved in banking, in food distribution. They are major investor in Jabal Ali. Mr. Batil Gandhi, prominent family that invest, there is a trading house investing in many opportunity, including manufacturing. Mr. Batil Gandhi is with us. Mr. Sinan Nabuda also, major construction company and trading house in Dubai. Their major specialty is building airport. All the airports in Dubai have been developed by this company. This is just, they heard a few days ago, because you know we have changed the time a few times, unfortunately, about the opening. So they came. But inshallah, we're going to come again after Ramadan. There'll be more people coming to invest. Now, the world trade, we spoke about growth. Africa, there is a growth. And there is more growth. And so, by developing a free zone, logistic parks, not just in Berbera, but also in Ethiopia and in many countries. Industrial park that create cargo. So the need is not really for ports. It's more for projects that generate cargo. Location of Berbera is very important. So for us, Berbera is an expansion of Djibouti. A continuation. We are in Djibouti, we are developing, and we decided also to expand the port of Durrani and the other ports in Djibouti. We are committed to Djibouti. I don't want to make any shadow of that. But Berbera is going to be an addition of the expansion. Berbera has a role to play. Berbera has the market, 4 million people, no ports around them. Why you need the port? Because it costs a lot of money and it costs you a lot of money to ship cargo to Somaliland. It makes the export of Somaliland more expensive. It makes importing for construction more expensive. So building a port, which is our art, we are in 6 locations today in Africa. We are in Djibouti and continuing to expand. And we are confident of the strong fundamentals of the economy of Djibouti. The Corn of Africa is very important. The expansion of cargo demand for Ethiopia, which is growing at 20%, it needs more than Berbera and Djibouti combined. The biggest problem for Ethiopia and for many countries is when there is shortage of space and not only the port, but cargo generating projects. We don't do only port, we do cargo generating projects. So now, Jabal Ali today has 8,000 companies. In Africa, we are in Djibouti, then we are in Sokhna, in Egypt, expanding again in Sokhna. We are go from there, we are in Algeria, we are in Dakar, Senegal, we are in Maputo, Mozambique, and very soon we're going to be in Nacala in Mozambique, which is in Pemba area. We are in Rwanda developing a logistic dry port park. We have many plans to expand in Ethiopia to reduce the cost of logistics. So our job is not anymore a port. We create cargo. And we gained a lot of experience doing that. In London, we have a big port with big industrial park. In India, we have six terminals. We are today 78 terminals around the world. The world is growing. Trade is going to be your revenue. Trade activities is what's going to make Berbera even more important. We are discussing the free zone and on the recommendation of the government, based on what they select, we will develop a land. One of the biggest problems, as I mentioned, facing Africa, growth is infrastructure. It makes the cost of importing very expensive. We are developing infrastructure. We are experts in what we do there. I believe once the free zone area allocated and finalized, we'll have our team planning it. And once it's planned, inshallah, we'll come again with bigger delegation of serious investors. Already, one or two of these investors decided to invest in Berbera. Already today, we spoke in the plane. They said we are. And one of them is raising his hand. Others will come to participate with you to develop. They're not doing you a favor. They're going to utilize an important opportunity you have made possible for the maritime industry and for us. We share a long history with Somaliland and the Horn of Africa. Not only we are brothers in religion, but traders have been coming from Somaliland to our country, and we've been trading with you. The traders of Somaliland and the Horn of Africa are your ambassadors in our area, and their reputation is very good in our country. Hardworking, sincere, trustworthy people. So I think we only have to gain from this. We will bring our experience that we gained in the last 40 years to Somaliland. We will be training people in Somaliland. Very important for us. Today, the most important ingredient I find in Berbera are the people that are here. This is the biggest wealth. I'm proud to say that, for example, when we came to Djibouti, there were not that much of experience in containers. When we came to Dakar, it wasn't. I was in Algeria, and our finance director was Djiboutian, and our operation director was from Senegal. And inshallah, one day we'll have an operation manager trained in Barbara, working in our port in Jebel Ali or in other areas. We need hardworking people. We don't ask for experience. We will give the experience for the people who want to learn. You have a big responsibility in developing your country. We can do one part, but you have to do a lot yourself. Believing in your country, working hard, encouraging the investor to have a very good experience. Because the problem is, you can always bring investors, but if they face one problem, they will go back and they will spoil it. And they will say, oh, don't go to Barbara. We don't want that to happen. Inshallah, we will work together. I am committed to Barbara, committed to the people of Barbara, committed to the president and the ministers who work very hard, efficiently with us to reach this milestone agreement. I am really happy that the start of the new management went very smoothly. And that's a good sign. It shows that the people in Barbara and in Somaliland are really serious about developing their country. And I think this place is going to be a very important place for world trade. You have a big advantage against Dubai because every ship that is coming on the fast highway that connects west to east in front of you, shipping line come from the Mediterranean across the Suez Canal, Red Sea, and they pass in front of Barbara and they go to China. And vice versa, Chinese projects with the One Belt, One Road, they come from the Far East and they pass in front of Barbara going to Europe. How can we make them stop here? How can we use Barbara to develop a symbol manufacture? You are much closer than China, and China today has made a decision to move many industries out of China. China is too expensive anymore. So they're looking for places. And one of them will be this one. Inshallah, I will be working with the ministers to go personally to market the free zone and logistic park and industrial park here in Barbara. I really believe of the viability of this project. I'm really proud and grateful for the hospitality of the people of Somaliland. Congratulations. And inshallah, we'll all work hard for the benefit of everybody. Thank you very much.
وزيرك أريمه الدبدة سومالا دكتور سعد علي شري أيام مناسبة دا كوت المامي إن مالين تري أي قيمة وين أولا يدهاي شعوب ترهير سومالي لان ما دام لده فريو مشروع أي منافعات أهمية وين أولا غران كتموريو دا سومالي لان دا كد بربرا مالقلين تيدو واتلابر دين عهور مركا لو قاضي أو أي كوكو ليستي حكومة دا تلاد هايسا أيوهو قاميو مدحوين أحمد محمد محمود سيلانيو dhammaan shacabiga reer Soomaaliland waxay qirsan yihiin in go'aanka lagu maalgeliyay dekedda Barbara uu yahay mid 100% sax ah oo ay mahadin doonaan bulshada Soomaaliland imika iyo mustaqbalka. Maalgelintan waxa ka wada faa'iideysan doona Soomaaliland, Imaaraadka Carabta iyo ganacsada maalgelinaysa. Barbara waxay noqon doontaa meel ay ku kulmaan beesha caalamku oo la isku weydaarsado ganacsi furan, fikrado horumarineed, kuwaas oo kor u qaadi doona dhaqaalaha iyo rajada shacabiga ku nool dalalka mandaqadan. Madaxweynaha Jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliland iyo xukuumaddiisu waxay u dhabar adeegeen suurtagelinta mashruucan oo maraaxil kala duwan soo maray, in badanna ay ku taamiyeen inay shacabiga reer Soomaaliland arkaan mashruucan oo midho dhal ah.
Today is another historic day of the long history of Berbera. Berbera is one of the most ancient ports in the world. Ships from every era called upon it. It was used by the Egyptian pharaohs, the Greeks, the Romans, the Persians, the Chinese, the Turks, and later by the Europeans. The international interest in the port of Berbera stems from its location. It's a natural harbor that lies on the crossroads between Europe, Asia, Africa, and the Middle East. About one third of the world's maritime traffic passes through the Red Sea off the port of Berbera. It attracted the attention of both ship captains and army generals over the centuries. The port is not just a facility of strategic interest to international businesses and governments, it's also a vital national asset. It's the primary port of Somaliland, the main exit and entry point of our exports and imports, and the principal source of revenue for the government. Berbera used to be one of the main maritime hubs on the Red Sea corridor, but its prominent position has slipped in the past 30 years, while other ports in the region received massive investments and modernized it to accommodate the new container traffic. Berbera Port did not for various reasons. Mindful of the need to restore competitiveness, the government sought to attract investors, and investors mindful of the great opportunities the port offers approached the government. It's this mutual interest that brought us together, that brought DP World and Somaliland together. DP World was not the only contender for the development of the port. There were five other companies, but DP World offered the most attractive proposition, and we are happy that we made the right decision. After a long and hard negotiations, a historic agreement was reached in May last year. The deal consists of two components, the expansion of the current port and the establishment of a free zone. We believe that the deal brings with it many benefits to both sides. It gives DP World a strategic port at crossroads of international trade and a gateway to landlocked East African countries. It offers Somaliland massive investment to modernize and extend Berbera Port to regain its prominent position on the Red Sea. At the end of the concession period, a modern 800-meter long container terminal at the cost of $442 million will be added to the port. The deal also offers jobs, skills transfer, and enhanced investment confidence in Somaliland. Berbera is already a boom town. Land prices have skyrocketed and hotels are fully booked. But the benefits are not just limited to Somaliland and DP World, nor are they just financial and technical. The benefits are regional. Ethiopia, Somalia, South Sudan, and the entire Horn of Africa will benefit from it. And they all should be giving their full support without reservation. I do not understand why anyone would object to it. The concession also cements the long historical relationship between the people of Somaliland and the people of the United Arab Emirates. I want you to know that in Somaliland, you don't have just a commercial partner, but a friend indeed. Welcome home. Finally, it's important to note that we would not have a deal to celebrate today without the commitment of the negotiating DP World team under the leadership of the chairman, Mr. Sultan. And without the dedication and hard work of the Somaliland counterparts under the direction of our president. The going was sometimes very tough. I should also mention the fantastic job done by our legal team from Siemens & Siemens and the technical support we received from Ernst & Young. Thank you for a job well done. We are still in early days. There are pending issues to deal with and challenges to overcome, but the smooth transition and progress made since March the 2nd give us reason to celebrate and confidence that our dreams will be realized. We just need to cooperate even more, work ever closer, commit investments sooner than later, and raise our performance to be regionally and globally competitive. The future is bright. Thank you very much.
Mudane Ahmed Maxamed Maxamuud Silaan iyo madaxweynaha Soomaaliland ayaa madasha ka jeediyay khudbad ku taalluqda iskaashiga ganacsiga ay Soomaaliland la wadaagayso Imaaraadka Carabta iyo sida xukuumadda talada haysa ay uga go'an tahay inay bulshada u abuurto fursado noloshooda kor loogu qaadayo taas oo lagu kobcinayo inay bulshada isku filnaasho gaadho.
Bismillaahir Rahmaanir Rahiim. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. مدن ريال مروين ملقي ما مسوين بيتهاي إن المانتي سغن ما منح بلدنا تاريخي كسن تان اسكاشي قد قالي أولي حيالة بضا الدلج وريد الزمالان يسو تقع إمالات كعربتا وحان بمانتين فالحد يدي الديري نوعه إلي نما تسير رسمي دكدة بالبراكة من نقطي لورية الدباتك الدكدود أي ما منشو أما ما القريسيو الشركة العالمية دي بي ويل تاسو قارا كانو وسيري بدونتا إلا وسو تشيدو ساحيبو يو حجيدو قان عسي أو ديري قلين كارا مالكشي بادن مالكشي بادن هور الله مدن يالي مروي أسرين تأيي بلارتة دكدة بالبرة وحي هاي بارتمر المعباد برنامج وحقبتك الحكومة دايدا وحنا مسان هاي إن مانتا الدرق أوها بون وغوها بون أنو كل سيكرنو دلكين نهويو ويا هاي إن نولادنا مادنو سياسات كان عسي أوف الفران تاسو إنو سالي كرتا إنو نهلو بالقش عالمية وكل سيد دنوذات mutual interest شرال مالمو لغو مرتقادو شرار مالما لغو مرتقادو وامر الله لحين يو مقدرد الدو وينو كوليغو و هبا لغو منشاكتو من نقال كمو مالمالو هاسي امدن وحي اساق يدا كغاري كرتا وقرا هملعب همي فوق يا هل أول أسر دق وياي تعب تلا وراك يسكاشي حلا الشعب يلقى ويسكت الشر لنا إلى هنا وحنا كت وين كت رسالة لنا وحربا مرتدى سومالي ترى هذا بي يصعب بيصعب هذا ويوم بالقرد لك مدن يلي مروين منطقة جيس أفريقيا وحكس على ترتن قرعسي والعية بدلة تاسو وحتار ولا شعوب تقول لقد جيس كافريكا سيدا درت السومالي هذا وكنت على بقاعد استراتيجية ومهم هو عيسو تسعود كنعسي عالمك حتى هو حين لقد بول إنه اللجان قادنا فرمك حكس على الدرك على جتاريس كان هاي أنا قو قابية هانكو كدولية على اكتراع حكومة دقانقل وذاك كاهي تلال دي رقشي سيدي مالجرين كوها بون لوغوها لها مرسال عالمي ايب الفراء بيب مهدي ريالا سيوي رمودي مالقشيغا عسرينتا يباراليتا ديكد بالبراء وحوين كد كبدالي الدونا نرشا يلقالها وشاد سوماليلان وحكالو ديري قلين دونا وديري قلين نقود دونا مشاريع كلو مهمة يشير كلو عالمية ودالك مالقشيغا سكو سمايا دينا عكره مالقشي كان هو مد فرصه شقه يو هو ابور فرصه شقه هو ابور دونا حوغا دليره الدين اي شغل انتو هايسو وحكور قاريا اسكاشكا قرعسي انو لنا هاي دلالك الدرس كاسي سنو كلا وحكور قاري دونا xilka jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliya iyo dalka Sudan ee Imaaraadka Carabta kaasoo aha mid soo jireena qarniyo badan awow ilaa ka awow mudane yaryar mar weyn dowladda Soomaaliya waxay qadarin iyo ixtiraam weyn u haysaa dalalka dariska yihiin oo aan dano badan wadaagno dalalka waxaanu haysaa xibo iyo jaal aad isugu dhow waxaanu aaminsanahay in shucuubta ku dhaqan dalalka geeska Afrika ay yihiin dad walaalo ah oo dano badan wadaaga waxaanu aaminsanahay in horumarka iyo wanaagga midkood u soo kordha uu kalena u yahay sad iyo sarraro xukuumaddayda waxaa ka go'an inuu xoojino xiriirka iyo wada shaqaynta dalalka dariska iskana kaashano adkeynta amniga la dagaalanka argagixisada walcadbadeeda tahriibka faqriga gaajada iyo ganacsiga sharci darrada ah hadda socotaan waxaa jira heshiisyo kale oo jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliya iyo dowladda Isutaga Imaaraadka Carabtu wada galeen kuwaasoo ah kuwa amni iyo ganacsi sida saldhigga military sida saldhigga military iyo shirkadda diyaaradaha ee Fly Dubai oo si joogto ah u timaada maalin kasta jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliya heshiisyada kala duwan waxay sii xoojinayaan iskaashiga iyo wada lahaanshaha labada dal xiriirka Soomaaliya iyo Isutaga Imaaraadka Carabtu ma aha mid imika bilaabmay laakiin waa mid muddo dheer soo jiran ahaa waxaan xusuustaa yaraantaydii markaan magaalada Berbera ku ballanayay qur-aanka kariimka ah inuu jiray xiriir ganacsi oo xooggan oo ku dhexeeyey labada dal ugu dambeyn waxaan jecelan halkan mahadnaq ballaadhan uga soo jeediyo madaxweynaha dowladda aynu walaalahan nahay ee Isutaga Imaaraadka Carabta sheekh khaliifa bin zayed al alnahyaan iyo weyne caadiga sheekh maxamed bin zayed al alnahyaan iyo ra-iisul wasaaraha dowladda Isutaga Imaaraadka Carabta sheekh maxamed bin raashid almakhtuum iyo shacbiga dowladda Imaaraadka Carabta sidoo kale waxaa yana halkan ugu mahadnaqayaa dhammaan bulshada jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliland gaar ahaan bulshada ku dhaqan gobolka saaxil sida deerahan ay u soo dhoweeyeen mashruucan casriyeynta jakada Berbera waxaan si gaar ah u bogaadinayaa waayeelka waxgaradka iyo haldoorka gobolka saaxil sida hagaar la-aanta ah ay si soo barbartaageen mashaariic dalka iyo dadka waxtarka u leh ee ka socda magaalada Berbera waxaan bulshada Soomaaliland ku boorinayaa inay la yimaadaan tala midaysan iyo tawfiiq wanaagsan isuna diyaariyaan maalgashiga iyo fursadaha dhaqaale ee dalkan kusoo aadan waad mahadsantihiin
shirkadda DP Well ayaa shahaado sharaf gudoosiyay madaxweynaha jamhuuriyadda Soomaaliland oo ay ku sharfeen sida uu qarankiisa u horumariyay halka sidoo kale madaxweynaha Soomaaliland iyo agaasimaha guud ee shirkadda Dubai Ball Wall ay madasha shahaadooyin ku gudoosiyeen wasiirro iyo safiirro ka qayb qaatay hirgelinta maalgelinta dekedda Berbera waxa kale oo munaasabada shahaadooyin ku hantiyay masuuliyiin ka tirsan xukuumadda maamulka gobolka saaxil ka degmada Berbera iyo madaxda gacanta ku haysa shirkadda DP World Berbera madaxweynaha Soomaaliland waxa uu martiqaad u fidiyay wafdigan ka socda Imaaraadka Carabta ee magaalada Berbera intii ay ku sugnayeen daawadeel intaa waxaa ku eeg barnaamijka aynu ku eegaynay dahfurka munaasabada lagu kala wareegayo maamulka dekedda Berbera ee ay kala saxiixanayeen xukuumadda Soomaaliland iyo madaxda shirkadda DP Well waa dhinaca sawirka.